Hello everyone. Today in this video, I will share some tips which will help you to remember Pterygopalatine fossa boundaries. So let's start. For that, I have drawn a square. These are anterior and posterior sides of the square, and this portion is above and then below the square. Then this is the lateral and medial boundaries. Now anterior surface is bounded by the posterior surface of the maxilla. Here I have drawn the letter M, but it has been drawn upside down. Now it looks like a bum, which means posterior side. So it will help you to remember the posterior side of the maxilla. Now I have drawn a P with a wing. Here P stands for posterior surface and pterygoid process root. This wing looks like G, which will help you to remember greater wing of sphenoid. So the posterior surface is bounded by the root of the pterygoid process and greater wing of sphenoid. Then I have drawn an eye above the square, which will help you to remember that the pterygopalatine fossa communicates above with the orbit. Below you can see the apex of the fossa. This pyramid apex will help you to remember the apex of the fossa. Now here in this image you can see a perpendicular wall or plate on the letter P. It will help you to remember that the medial surface is bounded by the perpendicular plate of palatine bone. Now lastly, infratemporal fossa. Here you can see three letters ITF, which means infratemporal fossa. F is communicating with the square here. It will help you to remember that on the lateral border it communicates with the infratemporal fossa. That's all guys. If you like this video, please like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.